motor series generator lab order code is 46595. So this is the master unit shunt motor series generator lab. There are three DC ammeter ranges 0 to 5 ampere and these are two voltmeter ranges 0 to 300 volt and ranges 0 to 300 volt. So here we will observe the supply voltage and here we will observe the load voltage and here also with the help of this ammeter we will observe the load current. So this is fixed DC power supply 200 volt input and this is variable DC power supply 0 to 200 volt input. This is the rheostat section where we connect the rheostat with the master unit. This is the external load. This is the DC shunt motor section. We will connect the DC shunt motor here with this master unit and this is the DC series generator. We will connect the series generator here with this master unit. This is the main switch to turn on or off the master unit. This is a AC-DC load which we will connect here and this is the rheostat to vary the load voltage and here this is DC shunt motor coupled with a series generator. So here this is the motor, here this is the DC series motor coupled with the DC, sorry, this is the DC shunt motor coupled with the DC series generator. This here is the DC series generator. Manuals and patch calls all are included with this kit. Experiment is to study and verify no load characteristics of a DC series generator. For this we are going to build the connection. First we will connect we have connected the external fixed DC power supply to the fixed DC supply block and external variable DC power supply to the variable DC power supply block. Now we will connect the DC shunt motor to the DC shunt motor block. So we will first connect armature. So this is the armature connection. So here we will connect the motor DC shunt motor here with the motor section. So first I am going to connect the armature. So this is the armature connection. So we will connect A to A here at 3 and double A. Here at 4. Now we will connect the shunt field. So we will connect F and here we will connect the FF to 2. Now the motor connection with the master unit is complete. Similarly, we will connect the generator to the master unit. So we will connect the armature to the armature section. So connect A to A, that is terminal 5, and connect AA to terminal 6. Connect series field. Here at the series field, connect F with F, that is 7. And connect double F with double F and A. So motor and generator connection is complete. Now we will connect the rheostat. So this is the variable terminal of the rheostat. So we will connect it here at R3. We will connect the first end of the rheostat at R1. And we will connect the second fixed terminal of the rheostat at R2. Now we will connect the ammeter and voltmeter. So first we will connect this positive terminal of fixed DC power supply to R1. Next we will connect A3. With the positive terminal of DC power, variable DC power supply and we will connect A4 with terminal 3. Now we will connect A4 at terminal 3. Now we will connect A5 to R3 and A6 to 7. Now we will connect V1 to terminal 1. Now we will connect V2 to terminal 2. After that we will connect V3 to terminal 5. Now we will connect V4 to terminal 6. Now we will connect the negative terminal of fixed DC supply, that is this one, with terminal 8. After that, we will connect the negative terminal of variable DC supply with terminal 4. Now, we will connect R2 at terminal 8. Now we will short these two terminals, terminal 1 and 3. After that we will short 2 and 4. Now our connection is complete, so we will turn on the trainer gate. Turn on the gate and slowly give the variable DC supply. Increase the DC power supply. We can see that the motor started running. As it started running, it in turn runs the generator and generator produces the output voltage. And here we can see this is the input voltage and this is the voltage that the generator is producing. This is the current that it this is the current that the motor takes for running. It is to study and verify the load characteristics of DC series generator. So for this, the variable fixed power supply and variable power supply, rheostat and motor and generation connection are same, so I have not removed it. Now we will make the other connection for the load characteristics. So for this, first connect A1 to R3. Now we will connect A2 with terminal 1. After that, we will connect A3 with the positive terminal of variable DC power supply. We will connect A4 to terminal 3. We will connect A5 to terminal 5. Now we will connect A6 to terminal 9, that is to the load socket. A6 here at terminal 9. Now we will connect B1 to terminal 3. And we will connect V2 at terminal 4. Now we will connect V3 at terminal 5 and we will connect V4 at terminal 7. Now we will connect the negative terminal of the fixed power supply to terminal 2 Now we will connect the negative terminal power supply, negative terminal of variable DC power supply to terminal 4. After that, we will connect R1 to the positive terminal of fixed DC power supply. Next, we will connect R2 to terminal 2. After that, we will connect terminal 7 to terminal 10. Now, we will short terminal 6 and 8 . Now we will connect the AC-DC load with the master unit. So connect these two terminal to load terminal, that is 9 and 10. Now our connection is complete. Now we'll turn on the kit. Now we will short these two terminals of the AC-DC load. Now slowly increase the variable power supply till the generator starts producing voltage. So we can see the motor is running and the generator is producing voltage. This is the voltage, not turn on. This AC-DC power supply, this is the main switch, and the order put of this AC-DC power supply is 46502. So turn on the main key. Now slowly increase the load. We can see, as we are increasing the load, this terminal voltage is also increasing. And we can see with that the current that the generator is needed to start, it is also increasing as there is more load on the generator. Like this. So this is the characteristics. This is the load characteristic of DC series generator. We can see as we are increasing the load, the current is also decreasing.